Tennis can be played in singles, 1v1, doubles, 2v2, team event, which is a combination of singles and doubles. It can be 4 singles, 1 doubles, or any combination. Then there's the mixed doubles, where a guy and a girl play against guy and a girl. Now let's talk about tennis court. Tennis court, there's a net in between it, which divides it into two parts, your area and your opponent's area. There's a baseline, you need to hit shot within the baselines. There's a service line, you need to serve between net and the service line. There are doubles line, because this whole thing is used when you play doubles. And then there are singles line, because this is the only area which is used when you play tennis singles. Rest of the area is ignored. So we're gonna talk about tennis singles, and then we will extrapolate it to the doubles. So let's ignore rest of the area. Then you can see there is a center mark. What's the purpose of center mark? So let's just say you're standing facing the net. Well, it's difficult to tell in this scenario, so let's rotate it. You're facing the net. There's a center mark which divides court into right hand side and left hand side. Every time you start a game, you'll be standing to the right hand side of the center mark. So you are standing on the right hand side of the center mark, and your opponent is standing on the other side. Every point in tennis starts with a service. So you'll serve. When you're serving, you're standing on the right hand side of the center mark and behind the baseline. So this is the blue area in which you can toss the ball and hit the ball. Once you hit the ball, its first bounce should be in this green area to have a good serve. And life gives you one chance, but tennis gives you two services. You toss the ball, if its bounce is not in the green area, your first serve is fault, and then you get the second serve. If your second serve is good, then it's your opponent's turn to hit the ball in such a way that the ball's bounce is in this green area. Once he has done that, then it's your responsibility to hit the ball in such a way that the bounce is in the green area. And this can go on forever. So how do you win the point? Well, to win a point, there are four ways. You hit a really good shot that he's not able to reach there. It's called winner shot. Or you hit a shot that it has two bounces before he returns. It's called double bounce. Third option is you hit a shot and he hits into the net. And the fourth is most common, when you hit a shot and your opponent hits it outside the playing area. So these are four ways in which you can win a point. Now let's talk about scoring in tennis. Like every other sport, tennis starts with 0-0, but in tennis, 0 is known as love. So you say love all. When you win the first point, it's called 15. When you win the second point, it's 30. When you win the third point, it's 40. And if you win the fourth point, that means you won a game. So you need 4 points to win a game, and then you need 6 games to win a set. And you need to win 2 sets to win a match. So you need to win a lot of points to win a match. So get ready for it. Now let's simulate a match just to go through the scoring and where you stand and how you serve. So 0-0, if you're watching tennis on the TV, you'll always see there's a blue pointing thing or a ball or anything in front of a player's name. That signifies that that player is serving. Since this is you and you are serving, there's a tennis ball in front of you. Tennis score is 0-0, called as love all. Now your opponent is standing there. Can he stand anywhere? Yes, he can stand anywhere in this area. But just think about it. Your first bounce should be in this green area. So think about the trajectory of your tennis ball. That's where your tennis ball can go. And he's standing right in the middle of it. So that's a really good strategic position. If you are standing at P1, you need to watch my video. You cannot stand there. It's useless. If you are standing P2, then probably you'll have to hit the service directly without a bounce. And you cannot do it. You have to let the ball bounce when you're receiving the serve. So that's violated. P3 and 4 are okay. But if P3 very close, you'll have less time. P4 very far. Ball might have 2 bounces before it reaches you. So P5 is a good position. Now let's start it. You got 2 serve, first serve fall. You have second serve. You hit a second serve, good serve. Hits and good shot. It's a winner shot. He got the point. His score becomes 15. In tennis, whoever is serving, you call out his score first. Or her score. So it's love 15. After first point, you stand here, serve here. Second point, you switch side. Remember, you stand in the right hand side of center mark. Now you come to the left hand side, and you have to serve in the other side, other green box called service area. That's a good serve. You won a point, so score becomes 15 all. That's an ace serve. Ace is very popular. If you serve and your opponent is not able to touch the racket to the ball, that's called an ace serve and you win a point. 15 all. Good. Oh, that's a lead serve. So basically what lead is, when you're serving, your ball hits the net and then bounce in the service area, then you reserve it. But if your serve hit the lead and its first bounce is outside the serve area, it's a false serve. In this case, you get a first serve again, good serve. He hits an outside shot, you win the point. Your score is 30, his is 15, 30, 15. Next point, good serve. Into the net, you got the point. One more, 40, 15. Oh, that's a false serve, you get a second serve. He hits an outside shot and you won a game. Remember, you win a 4 point, you win a game. Now that you've won a game, your game score becomes 0-0, but that counts towards your set score. So your set score becomes 1-0. Now you need to win 5 more games to win a set. That's how it works. 4 points to win a game, 6 games to win a set, and 2 sets to win a match. That's about tennis. Now let's talk about doubles. How different doubles is than singles. In doubles, 4 players. This is you, your teammate, your opponent 1 and opponent 2. Just like in singles, you stand to the right hand side of center mark for the first point. And just from this blue area, you serve in the green area. But because it's doubles, you get an extra area. So you can stand anywhere in this blue area and you have to serve in the green area. You hit a good serve. You won the first point. Just like in singles, you come from that side to this side. But now, since O1 is receiving this service block, O2 will go back and receive in this service block. So O2 goes back and get ready to receive the serve. O1 comes back, your teammates stand there, because that's a good strategic position. I'll talk about strategy in other videos. We don't have much time here. So in second point, you stand here and you need to serve in this green block. Once the point is done, you go back and then you need to serve in this area, and that's it.